3rd of August 2020. Good morning from Europe. Good Monday morning from Europe. Good afternoon, good evening, guys, whatever you are. Piotr here is LightForest Global YouTube channel. New month, new opportunities, new challenges. We start this new month, new week with crypto market update as the very nice developments we have there. So without the further delay, let's check the first chart. All right, there you go. Bitcoin monthly chart. We know that we are well above the yearly open. What is important that lately in July we were able to take over 10,500, right? That was really, really crucial developments. Right now, yesterday, there was an aggressive sell-off. There was within the 6 minutes, we had like 1 billion dump on the crypto market. But looks like both Bitcoin and Ether hold the levels. We are going to discuss Ether as well. So Bitcoin retest this levels close to 10,500, and looks like we ready to go a little bit higher. Now, how high can we go? I see for now, because we hit levels close to 12,000. That's the discussion we had, that for example, there was a bottom line, the range, right? 8,500, 10,500, or somewhere between 8 and 10,000. So move above 10K. We were discussing that the 12 is next one. That's what we hit. Now I have three more targets for the bulls. 12,500, 13,500, and 14,000. All right. We are talking about those upper shadows we've seen. Before, when it comes to the monthly chart. Let's switch lower. Let's have a look what we have when it comes to the weekly chart. Well, what I don't like here is this upper shadow, right? Is this upper shadow. It's telling me that there's some kind of the supply is visible around 12,000. Well, that's not surprise, but from here, attempt to go lower could take place. Now, so that's what I don't like. What I like the most when it comes to the Bitcoin chart is that we took out the latest supply we've seen on the weekly chart, right? So the previous week, even we've seen this upper shadow, we took out the latest supply we've seen over here. From here we went lower, we retest levels close to 4,000, 3,800, right? So right now, maybe this upper shadow, it's only preparation to retest levels close to 9,500, right? Maybe that's the thing. Okay, with the lower shadow, come on, why not? It could be a good opportunity to try to trade alongside, right? And as long as we are above these levels, as long as we are above this latest weakness, I'm bullish when it comes to the Bitcoin. Now, I told you about the three possible targets when it comes to the monthly chart, but also I have to tell you about the possible target when it comes to this latest supply. It's simply measure what we did to the downside and what we can do to the upside. 16,500, 17,000. That could be the target, and it's not out of the head. It's not out of the head. It's not the rabbit out of the head, guys. Why? Because it's the 17,000 is related to what we've seen on a weekly chart when it comes to this upper shadows, the Riley. So these levels are related, right? So it's again not the rabbit out of the head. So very, very possible. So both monthly and weekly showing that the bulls have more to do. Bears, when it comes to the weekly chart, bears have to regroup, gonna wait on the higher levels, or if we are going to get back below the levels of this latest weakness. So we are talking about the levels like 10,000, 9,500, right? So that's the weekly chart. Let's have a look what we have on a daily chart. Switching to the daily chart, and we have this I have to say it, ugly outside day, right? Because there was a new high, new low, and the close below the low of the previous day. Well, that doesn't look good, right? So from the daily chart perspective, supply, we have two levels of the supply. The first one being tested during the Asian hours is around 11,200, 11,300 at the bottom of the what we've seen on Saturday, and 11,850 the supply from daily based on the possible swing high, right? Now, what could be the target? Well, 10,500 and 9,800, 9,500 discussed a second ago on the weekly, right? So basically, if we are going to make a few things, we are going to draw the zones of the possible supply. That's the supply. And that's the supply based on the possible weak swing high, all right? So if that's the supply, if we are talking about the first one, so the measure is the one daily candle, right? And 1-to-1 from supply zone. What we are going to get? Well, immediately we are getting 9,500. Immediately we are getting 9,500. Again, not a rabbit out of the head, not a rabbit out of the head. So levels we discussed based on the monthly and weekly chart, right? So that's how it could be possible. So discussing short term, right? As long as we are below swing high, as long as we are below 11,800, 11,850, 9,500 possible, right? We can also make the measure from the swing high. What could happen? 10,200 also is inside this 10,500 broken supply. So that's how the Bitcoin looks like at the very beginning of the August. All right, let's have a look at what we have when it comes to the Ether, right? Here as well, very interesting things going on, okay? From the monthly chart perspective, all right, I like previous month close. I simply like it, right? We hit some kind of the supply, but we took out the different one, all right? We are trying to go higher, right? We have very strong supply on the way higher, okay? But then I think like 500, that's what we are going to retest within the next few weeks, as long as we are above 250, 245 is a new line in the sand, right? It's also the weakness we've seen right here. So the retest of that levels cannot be ruled out, but that's the new line in the sand for the buyers, right? So we might see aggressive attempt to take some profits. We might see retest of 250, right? But 500 looks like for now on the monthly as a new target. Very similar to what we have on the weekly chart, right? Again, weakness. So if we are going to make the measure, it's a little bit different on Ether because Ether was stronger, right? But 500 is what we are going to get when it comes to the targeting the weakness. Also, we have this nice untested supply in that area, right? So 450, 500 based on the weekly. Demand, the first one around 300 and the second one 250. 300 and 250 as a demand, 450, 500 as a possible supply when it comes to the Ether, and going even lower, going to the daily chart. Well, there is a huge difference on the daily chart when it comes to the Ether and Bitcoin, because there was attempt to create outside day, but the close was well above previous day open, right? So bulls here yesterday were stronger, but right now we trying to create swing high when it comes to the Ether. So I would be very, very careful trying to chase upside price, upside right here, right now, right? Eventually retest of the Saturday low 340, or then levels close to 310-300. We discuss it from the daily chart, weekly chart perspective. That could be the solution. You don't want to chase the price here around the swing high, as long as you cannot move the market. All right. With that being said, overall, as we are above 9,500 when it comes to the Bitcoin, as we are above 250 when it comes to the Ether, medium long term, I'm quite bullish. Some kind of the consolidation ahead of the continuation could take place anyway. Don't be trapped, guys. Have a good trading day and see you around the US Cash Open with another market update. Take care and goodbye.